Hey guys, welcome back to another FTB Beyond video. Before we start any major construction of a greenhouse or going back to the Nether or anything like that, there's a few real small things I want to take care of first. That's what this episode is going to be all about. First of which is this clipboard. What this clipboard lets you do is basically just make a list with little check marks on the side. I'm going to use this to kind of keep a structure to my episodes. Give me something to work on getting done in episodes. So anyway, to craft this clipboard, I can't remember what the recipe was. It's just a feather, ink sac or black dye or anything like that, paper, and a wooden pressure plate. So we can go ahead and check that off. Next on the list is a golden lasso. Let me go grab my jetpack real quick. I had it charging down here in this capacitor. I have some pens set up for animals way off over here. I did managed to clear out the rest of this valley and light it up with torches. I think there's just a little bit over here in this corner that I have yet to clean up. It's so far away, I'm not going to worry about it. We have four pins here set up. This golden lasso will let us... What's the recipe for that? It's from Extra Utilities 2. Oh yeah, it's real cheap. It also requires 8 XP levels. Which I died in between episodes. I think it was right over there. I was trying to farm for ender pearls. Anyway, I died and lost like 50 some levels. It was quite a bit. Anyway, that golden lasso will let us capture mobs and move them. I think it's reusable as well. And it's a really cheap recipe. I'd like to get pigs, cows, chickens, and sheep. I think that's all the animals. And I also did upgrade my jetpack to electrical steel, the second tier. I don't know if I showed that on camera or not. Okay, so we need string and golden nuggets. Yeah, I know I have a ton of string. I was getting string from those, I think it was flax plants. I think it was just like this, wasn't it? Yes. I want some more golden nuggets. I want more than 4, however many that was. Let's save some trips. One, two. Oh shoot, I forgot. It takes XP levels, so I guess I am only getting 2. Okay, whatever. Okay, let's see how this works. I did see some pigs. It's right over here. I don't know what mad as these butterflies, but they're everywhere now. Forestry? That's a new addition. I don't ever remember seeing butterflies before. Hey, you just right click and then it stores it in the lasso. Let's get the sheep. I know I want cows and sheep more than anything for the leather and wool. Let's go ahead and get another pig. Actually, might as well get them all. So these lasses do give infinite uses. They don't have durability or anything like that. It's a pretty handy tool. So anyway, I'm gonna go hunt down some cows and chickens off camera. I'll get back with you guys in a bit. Okay, I should have enough animals to start breeding, so if I need any more, I'll just go ahead and do that. So we can go check that off of our clipboard and start on something else. These golden lassos, that's a pretty useful tool, really. I think there's something in vanilla Minecraft, like a lead or something, like it's called. I haven't used it because I don't think it was in 1.7. I'm not sure. I could be mistaken. Okay, golden lasso. This chest transporter, I looked that up. This lets us move chests around. Kind of like the dollies from the Java mod. Looks like there's different tiers as well. First one's just made of sticks. Then we have an iron handle, gold handle, diamond handle, and so on. That's what it looks like. Let's go ahead and make a obsidian. I know I have plenty of obsidian. I'm not entirely sure how it works. I've never used it before, but we're about to find out. Obsidian chest transporter. I know it's supposed to work. Wait. Since when can you sneak at a chest and see what's inside? That's the first time I noticed that. So yeah, it works just like you would expect. You just right click and it picks the chest up. Does it work with these things? No, it doesn't. Wow, it even the sneak thing even works for these. That's pretty neat. Oh, that's not a vanilla feature, I don't think. I was hoping this chest transporter works on these storage crates, because that's what I'm using most of all. So this really doesn't do me a whole lot of good. I'll just throw it in here for now. Backpack upgrades. That's something I desperately need because here they are. There isn't that much storage here. So let's see how we craft those. What's going on? This mouse is double clicking again. Okay. Basic backpack, iron backpack, storage emphasis. Upgrade emphasis. Okay, so there's all these upgrades as well. Additional upgrade points upgrade. Adds another upgrade point to the backpack. So I'm guessing each one of these upgrades costs different amounts of points. Yes. Damage bar upgrade costs 2 upgrade points. Adds a damage bar to visually represent how full the backpack is at a glance. Okay, bowls, string, and paper. That's not too expensive. Eternity upgrade allows you to keep the backpack when you die. I don't know how useful that would be, seeing as we have that gravestone mod. Nesting upgrade allows you to place any backpack of a previous tier inside the backpack. Oh, okay. Advanced nesting. Same thing, but regardless of tier. Quick deposit. When you shift right click on an inventory with this upgrade, the backpack will attempt to empty its contents into the inventory. So that would be like if I go up to this chest and shift click with the backpack selected, it would empty it into the chest. That sounds really useful. Precise quick deposit. Similar to the quick deposit, will only attempt to empty its contents into the inventory if they already exist in that inventory. That sounds awesome. That would be really useful. Well, no, because that this is always empty. I know I could figure out a use for it. Compression. Allows you to specify a set of items to be crafted in a 3x3 grid upon entering your backpack. So it looks like you can automate a lot of things with this. small compression, 2x2, decompression. So that would be like a redstone block to redstone. Basic filter. Adds a configurable filter of items that the backpack will automatically collect. So I'm assuming you could add like cobblestone or something, and then any cobblestone that you mine up will be automatically sucked into the backpack. That sounds really neat. Fuzzy filter, similar to the basic filter, except the backpack will ignore damage values on the item. So that's like the cobblestone and mossy cobblestone. Word dictionary, mod specific, void filter. Automatically deletes any items you pick up that are specified in the filter. That would be really useful for cobblestone because I have an absolute crap ton of it up here. I don't know, I guess I could keep filling this up. I wish you could. Can you move these things without losing the inventory? Oh shoot. No, you cannot. Okay, there it is. I messed up. Actually, let's put this somewhere else. Like, down here. Seeing as though it's almost full. Wow. I'm surprised it wasn't lagging there with as much stacks of cobblestone there was on the ground. Yeah, that's almost full. So I'll have to make another one to replace that. Void filter, advanced filter. Similar to the basic filter, except the filter has 18 slots. And each slot has configurable options. Ooh, these are starting to cost quite a bit of upgrade points too. I guess that one did. I wonder what the recipe is. Oh, wow. Okay, the rest of these don't seem too bad. That one could take a while to craft. Mining filter. Automatically picks up any ores, gems, or dust and has a basic filter for other items. That would be, if I would get one of those plus that void filter for cobblestone, I could probably mine for quite a while. Restocking allows you to specify an item to keep stocked in your inventory hotbar, which is supplied from your backpack. That would be useful to fill up with torches. It would have been useful earlier when I was going through stacks of torches lighting up all that. This is just the upgrade core. Okay, how do we craft an iron backpack? It's just iron ingots, basic backpack. Okay, we can upgrade these two backpacks then. That pig has made it all the way down here now. I guess I have a friend. Okay, we need wood for a chest, I think. Wait, how was that crafted? A chest and iron. Okay, I did need a chest. 1, 2. Mouse is double clicking. Like this? Yes. Got an achievement for that. I'm guessing gold is probably the same thing, only. Yes, I know how to add upgrades. Yeah. I don't think I have enough gold to really. Yeah, I have 61 gold ingots, so we'll hold off on that for now. How big of an inventory do these have? Well, that's not bad. And then have 8 upgrade points. 3 configurable upgrades. So that one cost 9 points. That advanced filter was 9 points. What was the void? It only cost 2. And the mining filter is only 3. Let's craft a couple more of these backpacks, and I should be set. I don't know why I would need any more storage than that for mining. So it's leather, wool. I don't know if I have enough wool for that. Yes, I do. Leather, wool, and a chest. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Plus a couple chests. 1, 2. Whoops. Accidentally crafted 2 more chests. Oh well, no big deal. 1, 2. I don't have enough wool to make another one. And then I need iron. Wait, there's 2 chests I need anyway. So I didn't mess up. Put those there, put this here, and this here. Now, the mining filter was redstone paper. I don't know if I have enough sugarcane to make paper. And the void filter was ink sac. I kind of had to get some paper. So I'll get back with you guys after I find some paper. Okay, guys, I'm back. I went with a mining filter upgrade and a basic filter upgrade. That's all the paper that I had. You actually need quite a bit of paper for these upgrades. So anyway, to add these upgrades, I think you just do it like this. Yes. And then, yes, it's listed right there. Basic filter upgrade, 2 out of 8 upgrade points used, 1 out of 3 configurable upgrades used. And then the mining filter should be about the same. That takes 3 points. Okay, so now I went with the basic filter upgrade for now, because that's actually quite a bit of cobblestone there. But how do I... how do I set the filter? I just put cobblestone in there. Oh wait, I moved it down here. Let's see, let's just take a stack of cobblestone and what is this one? Yes, basic filter upgrade. Just do something like that. And then go down here and test it. This other one, this mining upgrade, mining filter. That said, it should suck any ores or gems or anything like that into the backpack. Let's just go right here and mine like crazy. And I see right now, that's not working. Oh, come on, where's some ore at? Okay, there's some. Iron ore. It looks like it did go in. Yes. Okay, I need to figure out if there's a GUI or something to configure that. I'll check here in a minute. Let me get this lit up. There's got to be a key or something to press. Mod options, maybe? No, it was options controls. Okay, yeah, here's all of the hotkeys listed. Nothing set for the chisels and bits mod. That was a mod that I kind of skipped over because I realized it was going to be one heck of a time sink. I understand you could do some really neat stuff with it. I'll probably come back to it later. I just don't have the time to get into that. Iron backpacks, equip, unequip backpack, open backpack. So how do you set the filter? Basic filter upgrade. Like this, maybe? No? I have no clue. It's not this. Let's see if there's anything. All right, here we go. Add upgrades. If the upgrade is configurable, you must have enough space for another configurable upgrade. Also, the upgrade must not conflict with any already applied. That's just saying the same for every one. Increase backpack tier. That's it. I don't know. I'm going to have to look that up. I think I'll do that real quick. I'll get right back with you guys. Okay, I got it figured out. What you need to do is shift, right click, and it opens up this tab here where you can put a filter. Was this the one? Basic filter, yes. So we put cobblestone in there. You can also name it, which is useful. So let's call this one cobble filter, I guess. And then we can do the same thing for this one. Oops, shift right click. So I'm guessing if there's no filter, it's just going to suck everything in automatically. So we'll just call this one mining filter, I guess. Now let's see. This should work like this. Actually, I ought to put that andesite on the filter as well. I don't see enough marble to really mess with that. Yes, that works quite nicely. So I should be able to mine for quite a while longer. The only thing that should be in my inventory is marble. Nice. Perfect. Let's turn that F7 back on. Light this up. It's storming outside. Okay. Uh-oh. I've broken into a cave. I'll check it out later. So now we can go back up, check another item off our clipboard. Storage upgrades. I've already said we need to build some more of these. We'll skip over that for now. Builder's wands. This is something I really should have built a long time ago. Spell. There's a mod in this pack called Better Builder's Wands. Yes. Very cheap recipes. Whoa. That hit that fence out there. That was really close. Unbreakable wand. That just takes another star. Which we're quite a ways off from that. Let's just start out with an iron one, just to demonstrate. And see how it works. Let's go ahead and sleep real quick. Let's see, it was like this. Perfect. Mode, horizontal. So how do you change modes? Or I wonder if you can change modes. Controls, what was it? Better Builder's Wands. Ah, first one. Change fluid mode. Fluid mode? Or change mode. I need to set a new hotkey. Hopefully something that doesn't interfere with anything. Let's just do Shift and M. That's red. What the heck uses Shift and M? Or I wonder if it's because... I bet it's because Shift is in use and M is in use as well. But if I use both of them at the same time, it shouldn't make a difference. So, what can we build? Let's get some cobblestone and just build a wall or something to demonstrate it. I really should have got one for all of this interior here. That would have sped things up quite a bit. That actually took forever carving out those hallways. Yeah, so basically, what these builder's wands let you do is place multiple blocks down at once. Okay, so it's in horizontal mode, so if we press Shift and M, vertical, extend up and down from the original block. No building on top, bottom phase. Why? I wonder if I need a diamond wand for that. I bet that's what it is. These iron ones can only build horizontal. Yeah, you just right click and it places a up to 9 blocks. And then the diamond, ooh, maximum of 1561 blocks. And then the unbreakable is 4096. When would you ever need to place 4096 blocks at once? Oh wow, you could upgrade them even farther. 16,384 blocks. That is insane. I bet that creates a ton of lag too. Let's not destroy my wall. Because this is all cobblestone too. I wonder if... No. I think that chisel mod modifies the damage value of the block. So it looks like it has to match the damage value as well. Let's put this cobblestone back. I really should have built one of these a lot sooner. I forgot the mod was even in this pack. So we can check that off. Let's go ahead and take care of the storage upgrades. What were those called? Small storage crate. The next tier is medium. And it requires a small storage crate, wood planks, and void crystal blocks. Which is just 9 void crystals. And you get those. Ooh, we have to actually get into the... Actually, additions mod. We need an atomic reconstructor. The atomic reconstructor is used to craft crystals, which are the main... crafting ingredient for most of the items from actually dozens. So we're gonna have to get into that at some point. So let's just go ahead and replace that storage crate I used, which was wood casing. Let's see, we need a log for that. Wood casing. Let's make a few of these. 2, 3. Let's make 5. Now that I have a tree farm set up outside, I can get wood pretty quickly. So now we need 5 times 4. We need 20 chests. That could be a problem. So I think I only get 8 per stack. I'll have to go out and get some more wood. Let's see, I left my lumber axe here. I don't know if I ever demonstrated this on camera either. These lumber axes chop down the entire trees, any log blocks that are touching. Makes things so much faster. No fast leaf decay though. I really wish that mod was in this pack. So just have to wait for that to decay. I think I have enough saplings where I don't really have to worry about it. No, this is the chest. We can move that chest down there. We can use that chest relocator, translocator, whatever it was called. Transporter. Put it right here. Yes, and it slows you down when you have a chest in the tool. So basically, these just replace the dollies from the Jabba mod. Okay. So let me put all that up. I put my axe in there. Still dropping saplings. Dropped a ton of saplings. Okay, we need four more chests. Just do it like this real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I believe that's it. 1, 2, 3. So it looks like chests don't have a texture for the Tinker's Tables. That's interesting. Okay, that should be plenty of these things for now. Put one there to replace the cobblestone chest. I wonder if these transfer nodes work with these chests. We are going to test it out. Had some iron ore in here, and some copper. Ooh, it does. I think we'll do that. And I'll do the same for over here once I get this inventory cleared out. I'll probably do it off camera. Can put this up. We don't need it any longer. Put these planks and sticks up. This chest, we'll put in that other chest over there on the side right here. We'll put these in there as well. Marble, put that up. I guess we'll go ahead and check that off for now. So we need that. We need to get into actually additions to upgrade these. I'll have to do that later. Power generation upgrades. Let's see. These culinary generators, that's what I was thinking of. Because we're starting to get quite a bit of... This wheat is growing really fast. Those worms that I found are working miracles. That makes those crops grow so quickly. I might actually plant a few more fields. But for now, I think I am going to build a couple of those culinary generators. And see how well they work. And the recipe for that was... Actually, let's look through these generators real quick. We have the culinary generator. Disenchantment generator. That requires magical wood and an enchantment table. I bet you put enchanted tools and stuff in there, and it generates power from that. There's no description or anything, so... Ender generator is probably ender pearls, I'm guessing. And I'm having a heck of a time getting ender pearls. Explosive generator must be TNT. Frosty generator is probably ice. And snow. That might not be too hard to get because I am right underneath a mountain. Yeah, it's not even displaying how much RF it generates. Furnace generator, that's what I'm using, and it's not all that efficient. It's taking a while to charge that capacitor bank I have down here. A stack of 64 in each of these generators won't even charge it halfway. Halitosis, I don't know what that's all about. I'll have to look that one up. Heated redstone. Magmatic must be the next one. That's probably lava. That could work better. Let's craft a couple of those culinary generators and a couple magmatic generators. Nether star generators. These things are awesome. At least they were in the past. You put a nether star in there and it generates a ton of energy. Overclocked, I have no clue. Pink generator. If I remember right, that generates power from pink items, which is kind of strange. Potion, obviously potions. Slime, survival, undeath. Maybe from bones and rotten flesh. So, magmatic is gold, lava bucket, and a furnace generator. And the furnace generators were machine block. Okay, this might take a while. Do I have any of those crafted up? Actually, I'll just show the recipes here, and then I'll craft some up, and then get back to you. Machine block was just iron, redstone, and a chest. And then the actual furnace generator is a machine block, iron, furnaces, and redstone. The culinary generator is the furnace generator. Looks like carrots, potatoes, or wheat. And then a meat. And then two redstone. That's pretty simple. And then that magmatic was gold, lava bucket, and a furnace generator plus two redstone. So I'm going to craft a couple of these in a couple of those culinary generators, and then I'll be right back with you. Okay, so I got two magmatic generators and two culinary generators crafted up, and I've also moved a couple of these portable tanks with filled full of lava. I think if I take this crescent hammer and right click on the bottom and change that to orange, it should automatically dispense. That's blue again. Let's try it now. Yes, it automatically dispenses lava into the generator. And it looks like it's generating 40 RF. Oh, wait, hold on. It's generating a ton of RF. Oh, wait, no, that's the buffer. It's got to be an upgrade from that coal generators, furnace generators, whatever you call it. So we'll do the same thing for this one. These are hooked up to this capacitor bank. It's going through the wall behind it. And then for these, we'll just put... Oh, that's all I had was 9 bread. Ooh, here we go. Generates 24,000 RF at 40 RF per tick. So 9 bread gives me 24,000 RF. And that holds 4 million. We're going to need a lot of bread. How fast is that filling up? That's filling up pretty quick, really. Okay, so that's our power upgrades for now. It shouldn't be too hard to craft up quite a few of these portable tanks and fill them full of lava from the nether and just store them down here in my generator room. So we can toss this. These furnaces will save. Put all my ingots back. Chest. And redstone. And that energy conduit. Okay, check that off the list. Now, last thing we're going to do in this episode is visit the mining dimension. To get to that, what mod was that for? I think it was at Aroma something. Yes, here it is. Aroma 1997, Dimensional World. We need to build a portal frame in the same shape as the Nether portal. That we actually have to craft these. And it is, it's like stone bricks. And this mining multi-tool will give us one portal frame. And to create the mining multi-tool, we need stone bricks. First off, I'm gonna have to smelt some stone. I'll tell you what, I'll be right back as soon as I get some stone smelted up. Okay, I should have enough stone bricks to get this done. So first off, we need this mining multi-tool, which is just two stone bricks, flint and steel, a stone pickaxe, and a stick. And then we gotta start building these portal frames, which is just that mining multi-tool and stone bricks. Hopefully, we can keep this. Yes, we can. So we need 1, 2, 3, 4 for the bottom. And then I think it's 4 high. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then another 4 for the top, I think. Is it just 16? That doesn't sound right. I guess we can put this portal just right next to this Nether portal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. I guess I had more than enough. Let's put it. We'll go 2 across from it. Ah, that's gonna screw up my torches. Need one more. Like this? Yes. And then I had it down in the floor like this. And then we just build a standard portal frame, like so. Yeah, I had 2 extra. Actually, I might want to move it over one more. Just so I can have a torch symmetrically in between on that pillar. I'll straighten up all this off camera. Put all my chiseled bricks back in. Like this. Like that? Yes. Okay, yes. And then that torch would go there. Or possibly like this. That looks better. There we go. So now to light the portal, I am going to go get my sleeping bag first. Sleeping bag, here it is. We'll put that up, we don't need it anymore. Is it nighttime now? Whoops. It was. I'm also going to eat real quick. And then, I think to light the portal, we just use this multi-tool. Yes. So to go through the portal, you have to sneak in it. Okay. And it's got to generate the terrain. What this mining world is, it's just a super flat world, basically. That's made primarily of stone, I believe. I've only seen it in videos, I've never actually been here. Oh yes, look at this. And we're all the way up at Y level 75. And I can already see quite a bit of ore just here on the surface. Look at that. So basically this is like I said, a mining world. I don't think there's any caves or anything. I think it's just stone all the way down. So this is probably where I'll end up doing most of my mining, especially once we get some quarries set up. Actually, let's see. This hammer is so nice. It's a quick way to get a staircase in. Okay, so there are caves. And that barely even filled up my inventory because I have those backpacks. That is so nice. So we shouldn't have to worry too much about mining anymore. And actually, we're probably getting kinda up there in time. I know I am. This is gonna be a long episode. So I think I'll just go back. And we'll end the episode here. As soon as we check off on our clipboard. I think I got everything done that I wanted. Yes, I did. So yeah, that's it for this episode. I'll see you guys next time.